All right, Ty, thanks. The governor declaring racism a public health crisis in the state today.
Yeah, Michigan, now the latest to make that move. Doug Reardon joining us now to tell us exactly what that means. Doug?
Right, Derek and Annie, a lot of places have already done this. States like Colorado, Massachusetts, Georgia, even cities have taken this step. In fact, Kalamazoo did it last month, as did Louisville, the city where Breonna Taylor was killed. But the declaration will address more than just racism on its face. It's meant to dig deeper than that. This now allows the state health department to work with other states to collect data and make it public to us. They'll also study some of the roadblocks that keep people of color from accessing top health care, affordable housing and transportation, education, and public safety. And the governor also announced today that every single state employee, current and future, will receive implicit bias training.
As public servants, we have a duty to understand how those tendencies impact our actions on the lives of others. This is not alleging that people are racist. It's recognizing that everyone has biases from where we grew up or how we were raised. It's just a fact, and that's why we've got to acknowledge it and seek to address it.
And guys, Michigan is one of only a few states tracking COVID-19 numbers by race. Lieutenant Governor Garland Gilchrist currently leads the COVID-19 task force on racial disparity. He will also, we learned today, lead the new Black Leadership Advisory Council. Derek Annie, back to you.